My name is Sherry Green. I am the Director of Programs here at Sabathani Community Center. Born and raised here in the south side of Minneapolis. And woohoo! Little south side action out there. So I've been with Sabathani Community Center for 3 years. This senior choir I've been listening to for quite some time. And they warm my heart every time I see them when they come in. I'm going to miss them because the choir is today. And I won't be able to see them for the rest of the year. So I am so happy that you came to see them. I'm so happy that you came to Sabathani and love this guy right here because he's been working hard all year to make this happen. So welcome.
Thank you, Sherry. Good evening, everyone. How you doing? Let's try it again. How are ya? Good. My name is Rob Graham. I'm the director of the Sabathani Vintage Voices. This is our 8th year together in partnership between VocalEssence and Sabathani Senior Center, and we're going strong and looking forward to getting back together in the spring after we finish this concert series. But we have a wonderful program planned for you all this evening that centers around the theme, There's No Place Like Home. There's no place like home. You think of the what's that movie again? Anyway. So this program features a wide variety of musical styles that center around the idea of home. And also, there are going to be 5 reflections throughout the program that our singers have written and prepared to speak to you all surrounding the theme of what home means to them. And each one is very different, so I hope you enjoy listening to those spoken words in between our musical numbers. And hopefully it'll inspire you all to think about what home means to you and what it has meant to you throughout your life. Maybe you've moved around many places. We also think about those who don't have homes and how fortunate we are to have homes. And so think about the traditions, the foods, the smells, the laughter, the memories, the customs and traditions that make home home for you, wherever that may be. Also, I'll just say a note to double check that your cell phone ringers are turned off so that we don't have any extra ding-a-ling-a-lings throughout the program. And finally, there's two opportunities in the program for you all to join in singing with us. And so when those moments come, I'll tell you how that'll go. But in your program, you'll see on page 3 the full program order, as well as a separate packet with all the lyrics for every song that we're singing, so you can follow along that way as well. So without further ado, please put your hands together once more for the Sabathani Vintage Voices.
I'm Good evening. I am Shirlee Callender, and I wrote a poem, and the title is Home. Home is a four-letter word. What those four letters mean will never completely be heard. Home usually begins in a physical structure of some sort that is usually shared with parents and perhaps siblings. Can't help but think of how most of us have come and gone from our various homes for business, work, and perhaps a lot of fun. I know this perhaps describes me and some of you. I'm sure you can relate to that, but we usually always remember where we last laid our hat. When I think of home, I think of traditions, favorite meals, family members, and we can't forget friends and neighbors that have meant so much to us. Some favorite memories are when we try to remember days in December, even though the snow would fall, because home hasn't always been a happy place for all. There were perhaps hard times that made us fall. And sometimes we have walked down lonesome roads and perhaps heard a whistle blow that made us feel we were 900 miles away from home. Someday I want to cross over into campground. As we remember the good food, the people, places throughout our lives, we sometimes just think of love, peace, and perhaps strife, because all of this is a part of life. No matter how much we roam, and no matter the circumstances, we know that we shall overcome someday. Then we can say, what a wonderful, wonderful world we live in. There is no, truly, no place like home.
Hoffman, and I would like to share with you some recollections that I have of home. When I was in my early 20s, both my beloved parents passed on, and all that I knew of home was to be only in my memory, which I kept strong, and as I had to deal with the immediate present. Home for me was Kalamazoo, Michigan. Yay, Michigan. Surrounded by family and tradition. My mother's wonderful chicken soup and her wonderful potato latkes that we had at Purim. And we went on to South Haven in the summertime every single weekend for the day. And my brother would go fishing and I would root for the fish. And my parents would visit with another couple and I would just play in the sand. And well, anyway, the years went by and everything was, you know, pretty wonderful. Not perfect, but you know. And my brother loved to teach me everything about anything he knew, so that was kind of nice too. He just taught me, took care of me like a little brother, like I was his little brother. So it was a secure world, and when I was 12, little changed in my secure world because my father, mother, older brother Herb, and myself moved to Chicago to be closer to my grandparents, both maternal and paternal, as well as cousins, aunts, and uncles, and we got to play with the cousins and just did all things that kids do in playing. This was special. That is where I spent the next stage of my life, attending high school, then college and work. But suddenly, everything changed. My world collapsed when halfway through college, I lost both my parents. My brother Herb, by then, followed a good job offer and was making his life in New York City. My faith became confused, shaken, and I was unready for this. I had no pattern now to follow. But with a new faith, I set out to make a life and a living, which took me to Louisville, Kentucky, and Ithaca, New York, moving quite a few times. And at this point, I began to think to myself, where is my home? I answered this question 10 years later in upstate New York, where I had set down new roots. And as one day I heard the geese flying overhead in the migration south, what I heard and saw came in the form of a lovely song, for which I will always be grateful. I would like to sing it for you now. Oh, the winter geese are flying in all the way from Canada. They honk and they flap across the sky on their way to the Bahamas. And I must admit, there's a part of me surely would go with them. But just for now, I think I'll stay right here in a place that I call home. But just for now, I think I'll stay right here in a place that I call home.
Thank you. and all of you just sitting there. Long time no see. It's good that you're here, though. Thank you for coming. Well, Wagwan is Jamaica Patois for, hey, what's happening? Patois is a Jamaican dialect that has been around since slavery. It's a combination of English, Spanish, and languages of the slaves. They used that to communicate to each other when they didn't want the master to find out what they were saying. Earlier, Patois was not respected. Some people considered it to be a lower class language used by poor and uneducated people. Louise Bennett, a Jamaican folk artist, singer, poet, along with Bob Marley, used Patois in their performances to express their identity and lived experiences, enriching their audiences with their stories. Louise Bennett worked to preserve the dialect as an important part of our heritage, a legacy for future generations. As a child growing up in Jamaica, Patois was spoken by everyone I knew. My Patois is a little rusty. I've been Americanized. Our mode of transportation back then was walking. We walked everywhere. We walked to work, to church, to market, to school, everywhere and back home. Buses were usually on the main roads. It's evening time, dinner time. I can taste the good things we had to eat. Red beans and rice, curried chicken, callaloo, hard dough bread, limeade, and chocolate tea, hot chocolate. After chores, we listen to the stories of the day. There's usually a loud game of dominoes going on. And we also listen to stories on the radio by Miss Lou. She would tell famous stories like Anansi stories. But when it was dark, someone started telling scary, dopey stories. You know, ghost stories. We had no TV, spotty electricity, no cars, but they were parked in front of our houses. No fancy toys for the kids to play with, but we had family. So what is home? Home is a place where you should truly be your own self, surrounded by people who love and care for you and willing to share everything with you. Home is love. Home is a feeling. Home is a feeling of belonging. Here's a story by Miss Louise Bennett about evening time. Remember I told you that everybody walked everywhere? Well, here's Miss Lou. She's been at market all day long. She's carrying a big basket balanced on her head, and she's coming up the road. Come, Miss Flo, take the burden off your head, my dear. Rest yourself at ease. Feel the evening breeze. Evening time, work is over now, it's evening time. We go walk the mountain, we walk the mountain, we walk the mountain side. Make me cook the pickle pon the way. Make we eat and drink, dance and play, ring ding pon the mountain side. Light up the fire, Martha. Shell up the gunga peas. Rub up the flour, Sarah. Feel the evening breeze. Evening time. Work is over now, it's evening time. We go walk the mountain, we walk the mountain, we walk the mountain side. Make me cook the pickle pon the way. Make me eat and drink, dance and play, ring ding pon the mountain side.
Yeah.
While we are paused, I wanted to give you a little heads up about our next number, which is the audience sing-along. So what's going to happen is I'm going to kind of teach you on the spot how to sing these two spirituals, Swing Low Sweet Chariot and When the Saints Go Marching In, together as partner songs. And so it's kind of a fun way to create instant harmony. So stay tuned, get your voices ready, and we'll come back to that in just a moment. But first, we will do our own rendition of Swing Low, Sweet Chariot, arranged by Ruth Elaine Schramm.
Testing 1, 2, 3.
Sweet chariot, come. Alrighty, friends. So,
the time has come. Are you all warmed up and ready? So, let's just divide the audience in half. So, just pick a side right through the middle. That's going to be group one on that side and group two on this side. And our choir will divide in the middle. And we'll be group one on the far side with our tenors and altos and group two here on this side. And so let's all sing each song once first, just that one verse that I gave you in your sing-along sheet. We're going to sing it in the same key we left off on. So let's try swing low first. Ready? A one, two, three.
Swing low, sweet chariot, coming for to carry me home. Swing low, sweet chariot, coming for to carry me home.
Beautiful. Nice work. Let's try Oh and the Saints in the same key. So do, 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 do. Ready? One, two.
Oh, when the saints go marching in, oh, when the saints go marching in, how I want to be in that number, when the saints go marching in.
How'd they do, choir? Pretty darn good, huh? So now, group one, you're going to be the swing low singers first. Group two, you're going to be the saints who go marching on in. Okay? So the way this is going to work to do them together is one, two, three, swing low. So low happens on the next downbeat. For the saints, one, two, three, oh, when the saints. So the word saints and the word low have to line up together. Are you up for the challenge? All right, groups, and let's help them along, choir. So remember, we're the saints on this side, the swing low singers on that side. So let's see how we do. Ready? One, two, three.
Oh, swing low, go marching in. Oh, when the saints go marching in.
Time,
oh, when the saints go marching in, oh, when the saints go marching in, sweet home, sweet chariot, coming for to carry me home.
Now let's quick switch sides. We'll just do it once through. So you're going to be the, oh, when the saints, and you're swing low. Ready to switch? One, two, T,
swing low, low marching in, coming for to carry me home. Swing low, sing a chariot, when the saints go marching in.
Time, oh, when the saints go marching in. A huge round of applause. That was awesome. So do you think we have some prospective choir members? Choir? All right. I'll think about it. You can join us this spring. All right. Moving on with our program. Thank you for singing along with us. You'll get one more chance at the end of the program to sing.
On the holiday home. It's called Grandma's Table. Grandma's Table. At a child's eye level, it was an expansive plain festooned with sparkling and beautiful things. Lace and crystal, silver and gold, elegant ivory candles burning brightly. Grandma's table was the center of our holiday home. After Grandma was gone, the table came to our house. At first, Mom dressed it as her mother had, but it didn't have the same magic. Both the table and the celebration seemed out of place. Before long, though, Mom made Grandma's table her own. New treasures mixed with the old. Silver and lace were replaced by Mom's colorful handmade tablecloths. Kids and cousins learned to pluck black olives out of inherited crystal bowls to eat off of all five fingers. But cookies were always served on Mom's special blue tray. I learned to cherish the new traditions made at Mom's holiday table, with all the love and laughter we shared there. As they grew, my kids learned to hold dear their grandma's table as much as I had loved mine. When my table became grandma's table, I'm sure it took me a while to make it my own too. But eventually my treasures came into the mix. I can tell my traditions have taken hold when my girls and I dress it together. Is this one of grandma's tablecloths? Mom, let's use the spoiled china this year. Hey, where's the olive dish? We don't always gather at my table for the holidays anymore. We can only manage to be in the same place every other year or so. And I can sense that another table transition is beginning. This year, I'll be driving across the country to be a grandma at my daughter's table. I will be sure to bring her one of the treasures from my table to make her own.
Thank you. Good evening, and thank you for joining us. My name is Antoinette Johnson. As we gather together this evening to sing about and reflect on what home means to us, the journeys we make to return there, the emotions the word places on our hearts, let us not forget that there are many who are experiencing hardship and are unable to provide for themselves and their families. Let us remember to keep them in our hearts and prayers and to think about the homeless. Think about the homeless who have no place to go, no bed for them to sleep in, or a fire with a glow. Sleeping in the rough in some cardboard box, taking life the hard way, all of its knocks. Living life so lonely, they begin to roam, hoping maybe someday they will find a home. Somewhere where they can stay with their own front door. Then the lonely people won't be homeless anymore. That was a poem by author William Worthless. Thank you.
Hold on just a little while longer. Hold on just a little while longer. Hold on just a little while longer. Everything's gonna be all right. I said everything's gonna be all right.
Just pray for us. Pray for us, please. Just pray for us. Pray on. Pray on. Just a little while longer. Pray on. Just a little while longer. Pray on, pray on, just a little while longer. I said everything, I know
we shall overcome.
Oh, wow. You guys are awesome. Thank you for participating. That clapping and snapping you were doing, that really helped get us going there. So before we give you one more chance to sing with us, I just want to take this opportunity to thank you all so much for coming tonight. You know, we've been spending the last 12 weeks every Tuesday for 90 minutes rehearsing for this program. And our singers come from all over the Twin Cities, some out in the suburbs, some right here in the neighborhood. And we're just so grateful to them. So please give these singers one more huge round of applause. I'd also like to acknowledge our soloists and speakers. So we have and percussion players. We have Miss Dorothy Jean Barnes Griswold. We have Shirlee Callender, Jeannie Hoffman. Just give a little wave so everyone knows who you are, friends, when I say your name. And let's see. We have Jean Heron, who gave a reflection. Phyllis Harris. Wilmisha Henderson. Antoinette Johnson, and Deb Parker. Did I miss anyone? And also, let's give a huge round of applause to our wonderful pianist, John Jensen. It is so much fun making music with John, and as you can tell, he can play just about anything. So, also, I would be remiss if I didn't thank my dear colleague, Amanda Timmer, on flute. All of the staff at VocalEssence are also musicians, and so in addition to being our director of marketing and communications, Amanda is a wonderfully accomplished flute player. So thank you, Amanda, for joining. All right, so I'll ask you, if you'd like, you can stand. And we'll ask you to join in singing We Shall Overcome, the four verses that you see printed in your lyrics packet. If you don't want to stand, that's okay. But use your outdoor voices, as our founder and artistic director, Philip Brunel, loves to say. And finally, thank you to the Sabathani staff, Sherry and Scott and their entire team, for really fostering this partnership. All right, so we'll sing in the same key we just ended in. And feel free to sing harmony if you'd like. Make it up, whatever the spirit of music moves you to do. And have a wonderful, safe night. Make it home safely. And please look out for our next concert, which will be in likely May of 2023. So we'll see you there. So here's We Shall Overcome.
Thank you.
yourselves a big round of applause. Thank you all so much for sharing your beautiful gifts of your voices with us. Have a safe night home. We look forward to seeing you next time. And feel free to come and greet these wonderful, wonderful singers. Thank you. Good night.